Hello one and all, it's CheeseTyme and welcome back to Stories Untold. We're going to do the lab conduct now, episode 2. If you didn't see the previous one, that one had more of a text-based adventure game. I wonder if this is of the same sort, or if it has sort of a different view, if it's a completely different story. We'll find out. Same intro as before. It kind of reminds me of a Stranger Things feel going on. What I know about the story so far is that something happened in 1986.
12-19-86-23, new session entry. We have myself, Dr. Alexander, leading, assisted by Dr. Williams, and in the lab itself, our volunteer, Mr. Asian. We have artifact 23 in the chamber, recovered from crash site B. At the moment it appears inert, showing no signs of activity. Mr. Asian, instructions for each stage will come through to your terminal, and we need you to follow them exactly.
Okay.
Now, some of this may be unfamiliar, so always reference the manual on your terminal for guides on calibration and procedure. Once you've calibrated equipment to match our brief, the green light will flash, allowing you to trigger the experiment. One last thing. Ensure that any equipment non-essential to the current experiment is switched off. You cannot proceed until your calibration matches ours.
Okay.
When you're ready, let's bring this back.
All right. This is a bit different. That mug, I believe, was in the previous one, so... U.S. Department of Experimental Science. So, okay. Anyway, like I was saying, in the previous one, it looks like this doesn't have a lot to do with what the previous one was. There might be some connections between the stories, but I don't know. This is all just speculation. I'm guessing EMH. I can type on the keyboard to select those things. Experiment 1, internal analysis. Subject, 1986. Is enclosed in solid outer layers. X-ray the artifact to determine its internal structure. Okay, so apparently we need to X-ray the artifact. Let's go to manual. X-ray. Concentrated light laser, acoustic resonance, drill press, safety instructions, equipment layout. I can also hit H to go to help. Press the keys bracketed in the top menu to move between pages. Press tab to roll over to the roll over to the test chamber by pressing tab. At the chamber, use your mouse cursor to select and interact. All right. So in the episode, I realized that I didn't have my mouse cursor actually being, recorded, since I thought that it was an internal, but it's actually just changing what my actual mouse cursor is, so it wasn't picking up my actual mouse cursor. So I went ahead and changed that. So let's look at the manual for X-raying. Required apparatus, camera, monitor set to X-ray, charged CC86, X-ray device, TV input modes, R3, IR, XR. So yeah, R3 is RGB full color, CLOUR, that's mostly a European spelling. This is the US Department of Experimental Science. But I'll let that slide. Let's see, IR, infrared, yeah, X-ray, okay. So we need the camera and the monitor set to X-ray. Charge CC86 X-ray device. Okay. Let's go to equipment layout. Let's see what this is. So from the chase chamber, from the test chamber, the camera, TV unit, amplifier, sync master. That's what was talking about. When it flashes green, you can continue. And the CC86 X-ray. Okay, so monitors need to be set to X-ray. We need the camera. Sorry, right click to zoom in. Okay. Safety instructions. Use safety goggles and gloves at all times. Do not leave the container unattended during experimentation. It is extremely dangerous to handle any items within the container. Please ensure your next of kin is updated at HR. Okay. As per your agreement, follow all instructions exactly. Okay. Concentrated laser. Required apparatus. Laser 2, light generator, set wavelength. Monitor set to RGB. Light frequencies for red, yellow, green, blue, and violet. Looks like it goes between 400 and 650. I'm guessing that's Newman. Acoustic resonance. So this is for oscillators. Required apparatus, signal generator, set frequency and waveform, amplifier, set gain. So we have square, sine, and sawtooth, and our amplifier between 0 and 10. I'm not sure what kind of amplifier it is. It says gain, so it's probably decibels. Let's look at the drill press. Drill orientation. So it looks like it's on a track that goes in, and the whatever the object is below it. Switch drill on, ensure all other equipment except the camera and TV are switched off. When ready, trigger sync master to normal to begin drill insertion. Okay. So we can come back to reference this, but our current experiment, we need to X-ray the artifact. So the first thing that we need to do is make sure our camera, monitor, and our X-ray device are on and everything else is not. So let's roll over to the test chamber. Don't need that, don't need that, don't need any of this. Okay, so this is the X-ray machine. How do we turn this on? X-ray. This is the CC86. Okay, so that's the sync master. Drill. Okay, so we need the camera. Camera's rolling. X-ray. Is this the monitors? Charging. Charged. Camera, hang on a sec. Monitor set to X-ray. How do I TV input modes X-ray? TV unit and monitors. I wasn't trained for this. That's a heart. X-ray. Okay, so awaiting X-ray data. Everything's ready, it's charged. Boom, done.
Okay, good work. The X-ray is coming through now. There's no visible damage to the surrounding organic material, but no signs of activity either. All output is flatlined. Okay, let's begin.
Okay. Experiment complete. Press enter to receive new experiment task. Experiment 2, surface reaction attempt. Alright, demonstrate the effects of laser light on the object. Try using a low-powered red laser to begin with. Okay, so let's look at the concentrated laser. We need red, so 650. We need the laser to light generator set to 650 and monitor set to RGB. Alright, so let's go ahead and turn off the camera, turn off... Nope, I don't need that, I don't need that, I don't need that. Turn that off. Okay, so, set this to RGB. We need this to 650. Nope, 650. Okay, make sure that that is everything. Laser, light generator, set to 650. Monitor set to RGB. Low powered red laser to begin with. All right. Well, I guess we probably need the TV unit still on, don't we? But it doesn't say we need it. Okay, yeah, because we're always going to be looking at it. Alright, everything's set. Let's... Red laser. Okay.
No reaction from first stage. Let's try a higher frequency.
Okay. Higher frequency. Green laser. So we're gonna set this to 510. All right. Try green. Demonstrate the effects of laser. Use blue laser. That's 455. Here we go. Blue laser. Sure about that? Because that heart's not connected to anything, and it's just pulsating. Okay, acoustic resonance properties of the object. Begin with generating a 250 Hz sine wave with the amplifier gain set to 1. Okay, so let's go ahead and switch off this. Okay, that's weird. So we're gonna need the sine wave at 250 Hz. And it needs to be sine. Da-da-da-da. All the way up. 250. And amplifier is going to be set to 1, but before I do that, just the signal generator and the amplifier. We're going to keep the monitor on just to see what happens. Okay, so yeah, we just need the amplifier. Is that right? Alright, set to one. Let's see what happens.
It's not much of a response. Updating the experiment now.
Okay, acoustic resonance doesn't seem to be doing much on that. 500 Hz sine wave, amplifier 5. That was 500, right? Okay, 500 Hz sine, amplifier 5. All the way up. Keep going. And there we go. And this. Five.
Seeing some fluctuations in activity. Should we increase? Do the risk of damage? What about the lock two? Okay, we're going to push further. I'm running out of time. Let's switch around.
Okay. Switch to square, maintaining current frequency and gain. Okay, going to square. Let's go for it. Okay. A little bit different.
Seeing good activity on this side. Seeing definite spikes in movement.
Yeah, I can see
I
that too. Okay. I will trust you and keep going. My ass. Alright, maintain gain 5. Square waveform. Bring the waveform up to 1 kilohertz. Okay. But I'm going to turn that off quick. Bring this up to 1 kilohertz. A lot of activity going on over there on that monitor. Almost there. Can I turn this on? Oof. Okay. Oh. Ah. Oh.
Full activity registry. We did it.
Did what?
You've made excellent progress. You're doing great.
Thank you.
Now we need you to stay calm and try to relax.
Okay.
As we go through these next steps.
Okay.
We're going to attempt to alleviate some of this discomfort.
Sure. The protective casing is off. Proceed to drill the surface. Okay. I'm going to turn all of this crap off because I don't need that anymore. Let's look at the drill. Drill press. Switch drill on. Ensure all other equipment except the camera and TV are switched off. When ready, trigger Syncmaster to as normal to begin drill insertion. Okay. Off, 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 off. That's fine. TV and camera are on. Alright, let's do this.
How do you feel?
I feel fine. Good.
Take a few moments.
Uh-huh.
When you're ready, we'll continue.
Okay. That was definitely a heart. But whatever that artifact is, it's glow. What? Hang on, let me just notify my next of kin real fast. Excuse me while I pull out my phone and just message I guess my wife and let her know that I'm sorry for everything. Okay. Is that off? Is everything off? Nothing else is working. All right, here we go. Hi. Okay. Hello.
Sorry to have to do this, but we have to know.
Know what?
I know how difficult this must be, but you can do this.
Okay.
It's time to remember.
Remember what? Hello? Can I help you? Hi. Okay. I'm calm. I'm bleeding, but I'm calm.
You're a proxy now. You have a connection to the entity's inner core.
Proxy for what? This thing?
It's like a conscious black box. It
Hello?
can show you its memories. Look into it. The visions will translate onto the screen to be something that you can understand, that you can play out.
Okay. New data connection ready. Gonna try. Wow, okay. Thanks. Okay, memory retrace. Temporal interface conversion. You wake up in a cryopod, struggling against the gravity. You force yourself up.
You can navigate its memories. Use the computer. Work your way through.
Okay, impact into planet's surface was torn a hole in the ship's hull. Poisonous atmosphere spills into your craft. You are in grave danger. You have to get out of here. Okay, my caps lock is on. Airlock doors. Craft is broken beyond repair. There is wreckage all around, and airlock door is locked tight, and the computer terminal adjacent blinks. Use terminal. You tap at the screen, and the airlock door splutters to life, slowly opening with a horrendous noise. The ship powers down to silence, having spent the last of the reserves. Okay, so this is some kind of alien black box that deals with memories. Excuse the damaged airlock and fall to your knees to the ground next to your vehicle. Every breath brings pain to your chest. You look around to see that you're surrounded by mangled metal. Bright lights pour through every gap in the surrounding wreckage.
Getting all of this. It's describing the moment we found the ship. Mr. Asian, please continue.
Okay. Around. The crash site. Smoke billows from the down ship. Exterior lights flickering on and off. Wreckage surrounds you. Looking upwards, you see unfamiliar star patterns. patterns. You need the star patterns above you. Okay, so move. With every ounce of your remaining strength, you move away enough of the wreckage for you to carefully crawl through. The lights that surround you now attack your senses. You squint at the light, trying to shield your visor lens at the same time. It is a circle of artificial lights set up around you to eliminate the crash site in the darkness. Behind them, an army of people all staring. One figure steps out, a silhouette, and walks towards you. Hello. No? Look at figure. The silhouette is bipedal and bulky. Some sort of mask covers its face. It beckons you to approach. Okay. Go to figure.
Your heart rate is elevated, but you're doing well. For what it's worth, very few of our test subjects ever make it this far.
Oh, that's good.
You should be proud of yourself.
What happened to the other test subjects? Hi. Excuse me. Oh god. There's blood everywhere. Forehead touch. Dr. Daniel, face mask, hello, hi. We awake. The room is silent, only for quiet hum of equipment and occasional machine beep. Your touch isn't yours. We are all as one. We move together in unison. We are in a bed in a small artificial lit room with a single door. There is some sort of writing pinned to the wall adjacent to a display monitor with wires that drape across the room into our chest. They have torches.
We didn't put this entity in quarantine. It expired at the crash. Whose memories are these? When did this happen?
Read. Writing? Symbols seem to indicate where our body they had to cut. We've been butchered and maimed over and over. I can't look at the body. Okay. Wires? No?
What just happened? What's that alarm?
We yank at the wires protruding from our chest.
Find out what's going on.
Together we all scream in pain. This action sets off an alarm echoing loudly down the adjacent corridor. Hang on. Look around, we are in bed in a small artificial lit room with a single door. Adjacent is a display monitor. Bed.
Stop. Specimen 20 has left lab 15. It's on the move. My god. That vision. It's not a memory. It's happening right now. Mr. Asian, I need you to stop what you're doing, please.
What? I don't want to know what I'm doing. I'm just doing what you told me to do. There's new data. Okay, hang on. Hang on. She. Hello. Hi. Through the door, we find ourselves in an empty room with a device on the table. It looks familiar. They don't know how it works, but this host does. The door closes behind us and lock clamps shut. We are alone together. Look at device. It was an access code terminal for a wide connection, allowing commanders to commander commandeer other hosts. Only you, we have access to these codes. It's time to use them. Okay. Preparation room. Markers and more sheets. Door to window on one side. The door can be made through. Has been locked shut. The other door has an orange alarm light above it. Table holding only a small device taken from your It's My Hour ship. Okay. I don't know what codes. Ah.
What is that? We haven't seen that before. What is it doing?
It's using the tool we recovered from the crash site. It's in our system. It's sending something across the network. It's broadcasting.
Mr. Asian, please. We deeply regret what we have put you through, but please understand it was for the greater good. We had to know more. Rebelling now could be catastrophic. You don't know what this might do to you in the long run.
I don't see myself as rebelling, but thank you. Okay, so, arrow keys to select the row, left right keys to change the glyph. I'm not exactly sure what I'm looking at. Or four. One, two, three, four, five, six. There's six glyphs. Is there something in here that I'm supposed to be looking at? What about you? What do you think? That one? No. This one? I don't know. I don't know which one it is. Let's see. Okay. We're good now. Did I do something? Did I do it? I did it. I did it right. That's gross.
They're all free. They're converging. It's over.
Oh, there's multiple of them. Hello. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There's eight. No, seven of you. And they're, why are you all staring at me? What do you want me to do? Do what? Did you click on you? Do you want me to look at you? I'll look at you. No?
The station. Please, don't do this. We mean you. We mean them no harm. Please, don't do something you regret. Wait.
Sure. Wow, that was weird. But okay. That was interesting. I like that one better than the previous one. That was a lot more there was definitely a lot of improvement between everything that you could do in that one and the previous one. That was awesome. Yeah, so that was the lab conduct on Stories Untold. In the next video, we'll go to the station process. I'm interested to see what the next one brings or even adds. That was intense, but a lot of fun. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will see you all in the next one.